Hey, here's a quick video on creating planets in Maya. To start with, we're going to need some textures. I'm going to use textures from solarsystemscope.com, but you can use other sites as they're all basically using the same NASA images anyway. Once you have your textures, let's hop into Maya and create the geometry for our planet and increase the divisions to a decently high number. For this project, we're going to be working with pretty big geometry to save time later on with our atmosphere. So before we continue, let's go into our camera settings and increase the near and far clipping plane of our camera. Cool, now let's scale up our geometry. I'm going to be using a scale of 270,000. Once we've scaled it up, press F to focus the object so we can actually see it. Now that we have some geometry, let's add a light to our scene. We're going to be using the directional light, as light in space is mostly coming from a source that is so far away from the object being lit that the rays are essentially parallel. I'm going to rotate this light a little bit and increase the intensity to 5 for the time being, but feel free to do whatever you think looks best. Now that we have that set up, let's start by making a shader for our planet. Let's apply an AI standard surface to our planet and hop into the hypershade. With our shader selected, click this button to show the input and output connections of our shader. Then create 3 file texture nodes and path them to the textures for our planet. The 3 textures we're going to want are a base color, a specular map, and a normal map. Although depending on the planet you're making, a base color on its own can also work. Plug the base color into its input on the shader and increase the diffuse roughness to slightly darken the texture. For the specular map, you want to make sure to tick the box that says alpha is luminance, then plug the alpha into the specular input and increase the specular roughness to around 1 on the shader. For the normal map, we're going to want an extra node called AI normal map. Plug the image texture into the input, then tick the box that says invert Y, then plug this node's output into the normal camera of our shader. Once we've got a working shader, let's add some clouds. If the planet you're making doesn't have clouds, then skip this step. We're going to duplicate the planet, then reset its transformations so we can reset the scale to 1, which makes it easier to work with. This is also a good time to rename this piece of geometry. Let's scale it up a little bit and then start creating a new shader. This one's going to be easier to make, as we only need to add an opacity map, which can be found under the geometry tab of the shader. Setting the image used here as raw will give you better results, and making the clouds a bit darker by playing around with the diffuse roughness and turning specular off will also make it look a bit better. The final step is to create an atmosphere for our planet. First, let's start by duplicating the planet, resetting its transforms, and scaling it up to be about double the amount we scaled for the clouds. Apply a new AI standard surface, then hop into the hypershade. Select the new shader and show its inputs. We're going to want to disconnect the AI standard surface from the shading group, then create an AI standard volume and plug it into the volume shader input on the shader group. We're going to change the density on the standard volume to be 0.0001 and change the color of the scatter to be a tiny bit blue. Don't make this color too saturated, as it will start to look unrealistic. Once we've done this, let's come out of the hypershade and try to render out our scene. Doing this will result in nothing much happening, as we must first go into the Arnold settings on the shape node of our atmosphere geo and set the volume stepping size to some number bigger than 0. Doing this will allow the object to be interpreted as a volume and should fix the render. From here, you basically have a finished planet. You can go back and tweak it to your liking if you need to. If you're going to composite this, then I'd recommend adding a little bit of bloom and defocus, maybe some background stars to finish up your render. And there you have it, a pretty quick planet. Thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, please like and subscribe for more Maya and VFX tutorials and videos. Cheers!